Hey guys, happy Friday to everyone. How are you guys doing? Mr. Trump once again strikes, huh? Absolutely crazy. So, guys, I see a lot of new names once again. Very glad to have you aboard. My name is Jordan and I'm one of the traders in the Traders Academy Club. I'm responsible for the European sessions. Vladimir is taking care of the US session. And basically the idea of these live rooms is to show you what we're doing in the club. We go over the list of trades that we've been following during the week and we summarize what happened. We show the trading methods we're using and overall just trying to keep it transparent. So this is how the report on our side looks like. Okay, you have a video which explains how things work and how to basically read and work with the report. We have a huge list of webinars, but those are the essential webinars that you better watch once you join the Academy, because those will help you tremendously to understand what we're doing and the way we're doing it. Then below, you find a watch list and the date. Inside this watch list, we have the symbols and the time frames. This is where the action starts. And of course, below we have a small place for comments where we're basically discussing in very short, summarizing whatever is in the image. We put the text here to explain. So without further ado, guys, let's start and go over through the table. Just one thing. Can you see the screen? Can you hear me? By the way, something also very important, the idea, thank you, Jose. The idea for this live room to be open is for you to ask questions when those arise. Thank you, guys. So if you have any questions about anything, don't be shy. No one can see your comments, right? Only me. So ask away. All right, Aussie Kiwi. Starting here with the heavy guns, monthly chart and the daily chart. Monthly chart is basically at the bottom of this arranging situation. And what's even more interesting is this cycle which previously happened, which means we can now expect the price to push up. Obviously, we're trading inside this range, so until it breaks to the upside, we cannot really rely on the bigger move to the upside, but at that stage we can go ahead and use that entire thing to trade inside of it, because this is monthly chart after all. So what happened here? We spiked through the bottom, and what we're expecting to see now is continuation up. In terms of price action on the daily chart, looks good. We had the move up. Previous low is still holding, and we have this not very convincing down move. This is where the divergences started appearing once again on the last part. This is where false breaks happened. This is where double bottom happened, and we can see probably better the double bottom on the 4-hour chart. Bottom line, we're looking for breakouts and continuation to the upside. Now, how do we trade that? It's entirely up to you to decide. Me, for one, is going to trade breakouts of the highs or impulsive moves. I'm not going to trade the breakout of this trend line. This trend line breakout, for example, is giving you the idea of possible continuation and a reversal of this downtrend. So many ways to do that. Don't limit yourself to just one thing, or someone said something, okay, let's blindly follow it. No, This is the direction. Whatever you feel comfortable with, go ahead, use it. So that's about Aussie Kiwi. As you can see, we still don't have the breakout or anything. Still playing around this zone. So let's see how this thing is going to develop. Aussie dollar is the next one on the list, and things here could be treated differently because we have a few possible scenarios. First of all, let's discuss the first scenario. The bullish divergences still remain, and from this cycle, we can see that 61.8 is right here next to the spike. That means there is a good chance we're going to see bullish moves, but we need to see a reversal first of all. Until we see the reversal, guys, we can't really judge what's happening, right? Well, we can judge it's going lower, but we can't say, okay, we're buying immediately just because we have a level in divergence. Unless you're trading divergences, which is trying to catch the absolute bottom or top, you can't speak about trend reversal based on these two things alone. That's the idea. So, going down to daily chart, we had some expectations for possible bullish breakout and continuation that was invalidated. The trend line was broken. This low was broken along with the bearish divergence, and this is where start to look for the sells. Now, those sells, for those of you who traded them, worked out pretty good. Okay, that was a trend line breakout, that was the low. We had this idea here, then we had the pullback, which also was more or less providing short-term opportunities. This is where we reached the previous swing, right here. This is where the divergence was completed for the second time. And we said that's a fantastic place to cash out either entirely or partially, or at least to move your stops to break even if you did not do so yet. Why? Because you have a level with divergence, which means possible, even if it's a pullback, you can cash out and then rejoin as long as you don't see reversal signs. That's why we said this is a great place to look for possible cash outs. Now we got the breakout to the downside. Let's use this one because we have more lines. This is the breakout. Okay, this is the 4-hour chart. The momentum started one push lower, boom. So in other words, we remain bearish, guys. Now, let me take you to the other side of this idea, which is the monthly. From one side, this leg was already duplicated right here, and we can say, all right, we're more or less close to it to start the reversal. On the other hand, when we use Fibonacci levels to determine the reversal and the end of this five leg structure, we are brought to this zone approximately all 60 zone on average, which is also the previous low. The divergence on the weekly chart, which we can see better right here, or on monthly, which starts to be continuing, not sure if you can see that, but this is how it looks basically, means that there is a good chance if we will be breaking that level, we're going to see that continuation as well. So that zone is very tricky. We can, of course, follow it in terms, we have all the evidence to support bullish reversal if it will be happening, the weekly divergences and so on, and good level. But for bullish to start the trigger and for us to start looking for buys, we need to see a reversal pattern. Until then, it's either neutral or sells. That's the bottom line. Yes, money, it is recorded. So that's about Aussie dollar, bearish, bearish, bearish. And I have a very good feeling about this thing breaking. Again, let's see, this divergence broken or not, the very last one will be very significant as well. Okay, that's about those door guys. The cells are pretty much working perfect so far. Cat Frank is one of those Forex miracles trades which are not exactly developing as per the plan. Neither they're moving on the opposite direction, providing good or excellent opportunities. Let's go back to the report actually and see where we stand based on the prediction. So here is one idea. False breakout, convergence, pullbacks looking for continuation to the upside. We had one push here with the bullish hidden divergence, but this is when that happened. Divergence plus three waves up, breakout to the downside. So this is where we start to get the idea of continuation lower, whether this is going to be short term or longer term doesn't really matter, but this is where the bullish pressure ends, at least in the short term. Now let me give you an alternative view here. Daily chart is trading inside this range, ignoring that move. We are looking for density of touch points to create this dynamic level, and by replicating the line from the top, it seems to fit very well. That's why we can use it. What we can see, guys, is that the pair bounced off of this level, and there is a good chance we're going to see the bottom. Now, it didn't create the move to the upside in a pretty fantastic manner, like cycles to be involved or anything. It was one straight push up on the daily chart. But for one reason or another, it is respecting this level, and we can't argue with that. That means this possibility, especially after the 4-hour chart breakout and now breaking this low, could be interesting for the sells. Just as an alternative, once again. Of course, if that happens, the divergence to be completed, okay, and we get the reversals for bullish, we can be enjoying bullish moves. It is still inside the range. It's going to be in the medium, in the middle part of the range, right here, approximately. So that works. I have no issues with this thing going up or down as long as it provides moves. Okay, we need volatility to make money. And usually when it's not that clear in terms of cycles and when things are not going as per your expectation, you need to adapt. You need to see and accept possible alternatives to your plan. If you want to trade the alternatives, of course. We have many people who stick to one situation or one scenario only. They, for some reason, are looking for buys. This is the pullback. So unless they get what they're looking for to buy, there is no other plan involved for this pair on that time frame, for that cycle, for example. Okay? I personally try to be more flexible. I'm not, I don't know, a crystal ball that can predict what the market is going to do. I have scenarios, I have plans. I follow both of them. Sometimes, if it's a range, for example, you follow both directions. You're looking for either breakout. Let's say this is bearish move. You're looking for breakout and continuation up, whether this is going to be correction or reversal, or continuation lower for extended cycle that was created previously. Okay, so when this happens, in my opinion, there is no harm in having two plans or two scenarios prepared for the different situations. And that cut franc falls into this category. We have the convergence, divergence, pullback, continuation with hidden looks awesome, but it's not being delivered. No problem. So we can have an alternative plan for the sales, which would be based on the channel. Okay? Any questions, guys? I hope this is not confusing. If it's confusing, please point me to the right direction. I'll try to explain it again. All right, so cat franc covered. Eurocat is a beauty which we are trading for some time. Weekly chart is providing us with multiple cycles. All of them are suggesting the same thing. That's not right. This is right. So basically, once we broke below this very, very, very strong critical support zone, we said, perfect, we're looking for continuation lower. The divergence here is broken. The divergence here is broken as well. So doesn't matter where and how we look at it, we are basically covered for the bearish continuation. Now, once again, I'm going to have invalidations and cover both scenarios. What do I mean by that? I mean that since this level is very critical, if we are correct in our analysis for bearish continuation, we want for the price, if it's going to correct up to this point, to stop here. If we get breakout above this thing, then something is going on. Then we need to revise what we're doing, reanalyze the situation, consult with divergences, consult with intraday cycles, and try to figure out why and what is happening at the moment. Okay, so I have invalidation point for the sells, and my biggest wish for this pair is to just push as closer as possible to this zone. Why? Because this is the best price for me to sell from a critical, massive weekly resistance. Then the risk reward, of course, is ideal, and we are looking for this thing to continue lower. And when we place multiple fibos, let me just change the color so you can see slightly better. When we place multiple fibos based on the different cycles, you can see where they overlap. So that was the first massive magnet zone, which was broken. And this is where we want to see continuation. So we have a few levels on the way down where we can be cashing out, for example. But overall, this is going to be one of the critical levels as well, where we have overlapping of two Fibonacci's. And then we have the next zone where we have three levels. Okay, but let's first of all focus on this one because that could take even months to develop. No need to discuss further than that. So Eurocad remains bearish. We just need to see something beautiful developing. And sorry guys, but this right here is really not tradable for me. At least I don't know how to trade it. If you have clue and you're making money out of it, well done, perfect. For me, it's untradeable. I want to see something clearer and possible entries would be delivered then. This situation, by the way, could be treated as a range or a channel for short term. Of course, the preferred direction here would be sell the top, not buy the bottom. If you're into the short term trading and ideas. Eurofranc. Now, Eurofranc is currently trading inside this double cycle, and many interesting things started happening. Now, the expectation based on this cycle is to continue higher as long as we're holding, first of all, this low. Then, if it breaks, we have the 100 zone to confirm once again the possible continuation up. And this is again where we can have multiple ideas and scenarios. And by the way, this is, in my opinion, one of the most valuable parts or features of the Traders Academy Club, because Vlad is usually focusing on its method, which is the cycles. He's usually focused on the hard time frame, setting directions, and so on. On the other hand, I'm applying slightly different methods to confirm my trades, and it's usually shorter term oriented, which means sometimes even 15 minute chart, 1 hour, 4 hour confirmed with daily. That gives you the perfect opportunity, guys, to choose or pick from either of them, or you can be picking directions from one, trade ideas from the other one, and so on. I mean, you can have all kinds of combinations here to make it fit your personal style. And Eurofranc is the perfect example. So one doesn't change the other. Vlad is looking for this cycle, which started giving the divergences and so on, and that's perfectly fine. On the other hand, I'm not seeing, because I'm looking for other kind of confirmation for the buys, not just the 1 hour chart here, which, by the way, pushed up perfect, but then this is where it was blocked. And then when you start playing with the lower time frames, you have a range. And for me, the idea was simple. If we break above trend line and the range and this massive resistance zone, then I'll be looking for pullbacks to buy. And this is where we both agree we're going to do that. On the other hand, since we're currently in a bearish trend and we come to place where the price is obviously having issues to break above and confirm this bullish idea, let's not forget, again, we're in a bearish trend, which means any pullback for me is an opportunity to sell it. And then you go back to scenario number two, which is the sells. And you start counting and trying to create a checklist that will give you trigger or no trigger. What do? We go to the daily chart and we start looking at divergences and so on. Do we have anything in terms of divergence that helps us? Not really, because we have false convergence, which pushed the price higher. We got this spike up, and basically that's a game over. So MACD in this case doesn't help me at all. Then we have levels. I have fantastic 61.8, where the price reached and is currently testing to see if we can break above or not. However, this is also the place where we have that previous zone right here. And when we take the bottom of this zone together with the Fibo, we create the resistance zone right here. And as we can see, that resistance zone is holding. That happens in confluence with the trend line. So overall, daily is somehow giving us the suggestion that we're at a perfect level to sell, because the stop loss can be tiny versus the potential reward and the continuation, which first of all will be the previous swing. And then we have the Fibo level. Okay, so this is where things start to become interesting once again. That's from daily. Then we drop to the 4 hour chart, and in terms of divergences, we can start seeing the bearish hidden divergence and the pressure from this divergence here. So if that would be the case, we need to confirm it. And on the lower time frame, we got the confirmation. One leg divergence appeared. Now, we can't really speak about breakouts here below the low, because that's not a real low. However, all that said, okay, there is a very good chance for continuation, but we need to find a way to join this move if it's going to continue lower. And since the price later on created the range, that was the perfect opportunity, the perfect entry or setup for entry that we could use. So this is where we can mark the extreme zones along with the inner levels. We have one here and here and that. So that's the 1 hour chart range, and boom, we have the breakout at the bottom of it, close and so on. That, together with everything else that we mentioned, would make sense for sales. Of course, if you have other things on that checklist, which are not confirmed, then the risk immediately goes lower. The more check marks you have on your list, you can get closer to the full risk in terms of percentages if you're trading percentages per trade. So Eurofranc, again, guys, was very interesting situation in my opinion. And it pays, it continues to pay. We're getting closer to that 100% extension. And this is where, once again, if the divergence holds, we can start looking then for the possible bullish opportunities. So well done for those of you who managed to also catch it. Then we go to Eurodollar, which finally made the move to that 61.8 level of this cycle, the big one. Finally made the move and reached it. Now the bullish pressure is obvious. We have plenty of divergences on the way, even though this is, well, not exactly amazing swings created inside of it. But the lack of momentum is obviously and clearly there. That, along with the previous five-leg structure, which is supposed to provide pullbacks and continuations, makes sense for us to look for buys. And of course, that's the weekly chart. This is what is suggested. But until we get the confirmations, we cannot do that. What we can do is look for entries in the current ongoing market situation. This is where the breakout of the trend line happened. The massive supportive area was also broken. Divergences are gone. We start creating momentum confirmed by the indicator, which is critical in that moment. And the previous low was also broken to the downside. So all that is telling us that was the bottom, by the way, of the range here that we've been following for weeks. This is where the momentum started gaining that power. And no confirmation for continuation to the upside. Boom, we got the breakout lower, continuing and looking for this zone right there. So that paid, and I do believe we still have one more leg, at least one more leg. I'm talking about the short term now. This is the 4-hour chart, which is going to provide us with probably one more sell opportunity. So what do we do? We have the previous breakout. I'm taking here the extreme point, the swing from the 4-hour chart, whatever is visible here. And obviously, this zone is confirmed to be positive for us, creates the resistance now, what previously used to be a support. So we got the breakout. Now we're probably going to test. And if this test holds and we remain below that previous high, we can be looking for sells. I'm going to clean up my chart now here live with you guys and start looking for further confirmation of these levels. This is the big trend line and this is the small one. So basically, that's how things start to form a plan in our head. And I'm going to steal that and place it here. And boom, this is basically a good zone for us to look for these sell opportunities. Why sell opportunities? First of all, there is no divergence. We get a breakout of this massive zone along with momentum. That on its own means nothing. We can still just fly to the upside. But when it comes with the zone and the level, it starts to become very interesting. On the other hand, we have the weekly, so we need to be careful and we need to pinpoint precisely the next sell opportunity if it will be delivered. So what do we see on the 1-hour chart? We see that hidden divergence formed and it started developing into continuing divergence, which on the lower time frames we'll be able to see as a regular divergence. So if I drop to 15-minute chart, or to the 30 minute chart, you can see it as regular divergence here, right? Pretty much telling us the same thing. So I would be following this possible ABCD pattern, corrective pattern in two waves. Price is currently inside the massive resistance level. And this is where I would try to find myself an entry for a sell. Okay, simple, clear, good risk reward ratio, tiny exposure, because if it breaks and it continues to move lower, we have plenty of room to the downside to go ahead and reach the next levels, guys. And when you're dealing with the 1 hour chart or 30 minute or 15 minute, the intraday charts, then you can really fine tune your entry. Of course, there is go slightly higher. It's not 4 hour chart breakout or anything, but that's why we start from the weekly. We get the direction, we get the levels, and only the actual execution of the trade happens on the lower time frames in order to get the optimum entry and risk reward ratio. So that's about euro dollar. Pound Aussie. We're dealing here with the weekly chart alone because of this cycle. This is the cycle, and the target for this cycle is the 50%, which was not yet reached. So when we go to the actual live chart, here is the weekly. That's the zone, guys. Then we can see cycle forming, first attempt to break, push, another push down, no close below again, and this time we formed one leg divergence, which I'm pretty sure we can find on the lower time frame as a regular divergence right here. That means this is currently the most recent high. That high fits together with the 61.8 of the daily cycle and the trend line. What does that mean? That means we have a key level right here. And immediately that becomes my validation for possible sell opportunities. Of course, the best place to look for sales would be as closer as possible to this place, to that zone. If we get there, we get the confirmation for the reversal. And the reversal in that case means the short-term bullish move. Let's say this is 1 hour chart. This is short-term bullish momentum, right? So we, technically speaking, we're looking for end of this bullish trend, 1 hour chart bullish trend, that will give us an entry for sell. That's all. That means on the 4 hour chart, we want to see hidden divergences. We want to see false breaks. And all the other techniques we're using in the Traders Academy Club to confirm that given entry. That's scenario number one. Scenario number one, always, guys, always, the first scenario is the bounce off of the level. Scenario number two always is the breakout. Why? Because the price, the current price at the moment, live market, is below that level. That's why the first assumption is bouncing, not breaking. Hope that makes sense. So again, we're going to have two scenarios. If that happens, we know that we have the inner cycle, which is the daily, inner of weekly, I mean. And this daily cycle can provide us with short-term bullish opportunities. So if that breaks, we have the false breaks, looks good. Possible pullback short-term intraday buy opportunities could be provided. If not, that means possible range if it goes closer to this zone and it starts moving lower. It means possible range or continuation to the next zone. We have no idea which one is it going to be. But we know that if it will be providing sell opportunities, we have at least this level to trade it towards, right? And that's, I don't know, the overall move is around 300 points. So let's say we have 100 pips here to take profit, right? More than enough to make some money. So there you go. Again, we create two plans, breakout or bounce of the zone. Use the confirmations and you're set to go. And as long as it comes to weekly chart, that one remains bearish. This is where we got the double top. This is where we got the convergences. So no doubts, we're looking for further continuation lower. There is nothing stopping it at the moment. And of course, the target is still there. All right, then we have cable, which is also extremely sensitive. Well, basically all of the pounds are super sensitive due to the fundamentals at the moment. Just like the dollar and the yen because of Mr. Trump. So it's a volatile time. But back to cable, guys. This is the weekly cycle we're following, and currently this cycle is coming and trying to break the 61.8. There is still possible divergence for us that puts some kind of bullish pressure, but keep in mind the histogram starts to point down, starts to create momentum, right? It's not shrinking. So that's about weekly. Then on the daily chart, we can see a previously formed magnet zone was, sliced right into immediately. No spikes, no nothing, just boom, one candle to the downside, breaking below it. So clearly there is something which is moving this thing, and that thing is the fundamentals. And the question is, hold on, did we cover the 4-hour chart? The question is, what do we do now? So we had the opportunity to sell the rallies. If you caught that, well done. Now, when we go to the live chart, we are going to see that currently the price is trading inside a very strong zone. This is also where we got the false break. And divergence with false breaks means possible pullbacks. That's why I'm saying, if you're currently in a sell, good time to start cashing out, or at least protect your capital against corrections or reversals. Bottom line, possibility for pullbacks, bullish moves acceptable. In the longer run, of course, we are looking for possible continuation as long as this level will be broken. So that's about cable. Mute, close, stops to the right. Dollar cut. Now this one is interesting. We covered this situation in the beginning of the week, I believe it was, about impulsive move, which then we said we can be trading the short-term pullbacks or immediate continuation. Doesn't really matter. What we knew at that stage is we need to see pullback after this move here. And we got the pullback right there. And then the question is whether we're going to continue lower or we're going to continue higher. Because many times, technically, first of all, we're in a bearish trend. Problem is, we can find impulsive moves and then immediate continuation. That's not precisely the case, but just for the sake of the example, bear with me, okay? It does happen, guys. It's not always 3 plus 2 equals continuation, no. Or it's not always correction comes in ABCD, no. It's a bit more complex and we need to adapt to this. And the way to do so is by accepting both scenarios. So if you're going to trade this part, perfect. But then you need to start looking at possible signs for either continuation to the upside or to the downside. In that case, we had attempt to break lower. It didn't close, but it created convergence right here. For me, this is an idea for continuation to the downside. And that sell setup would be failing. On the other hand, the way Vlad sees it, this is hidden divergence right here, which is also correct. And we have 3 plus 2, And once this trend line is broken, we can expect for this pair to create bigger ABCD correction, which is going to be basically ABCD on the daily chart. Who says, sir, might I just saw your question, how would you set up the entry? Can you please tell me which time frame is that? Not time frame, which pair are you referring to? And I'll go back to it after the workout. Euro dollar, okay. So that seems logical, and we anticipated this continuation for bigger ABCD. However, the issue in my opinion here is this. We're breaking the trend line in a place where we're super close to the 61.8 of that move. The next problem is we already had one divergence with the first false break and attempt to create convergence. And the further problem here would be that we're still under bearish pressure from this divergence, which is not complete, it is just potential, but the pressure is there. So this is where, if we move on to the daily chart, we can see hidden divergences. And hidden divergence on daily confirmed on the 4-hour chart, breakout or no breakout, along with level above my head here for the buys, for me this is strictly no buy, guys. Yes, I do expect this move. It might go here or stop here. I have no clue. Impulsive wave continuation. On this part, we can all agree. But having all these signs against you means this thing could simply start dropping any second. And this is not the kind of trade I want to be involved in. So in my opinion, the better option here would be to follow up for possible sales. Now, if we look at the actual chart, the current chart, you'll see that that was false break number one. Here we got false break number two already. Okay? So that's two false breaks along with 61.8, which once again confirms the aggressiveness of this thing. So I don't know. I mean, these kind of situations, even if they work, I don't care. I'd rather not be there. It's a gamble to wait for this level to be reached. And then we can look at the weekly chart, which was broken and so on and so forth. So overall, short term, we might be looking at these continuations to the upside, but in my opinion, they're absolutely not tradable. We can just use them in our analysis to have an idea what should be happening according to us in the next step after this thing here is finished. And in my opinion, that should be a move down. All right, question was euro dollar. How would you set up the entry? You mean where would I enter? I'm not going to give you a signal, mate. Sorry. It is against the law. I think we covered like almost giving the signal there, but I'm not going to pinpoint it. I don't have license. It is strictly illegal for me to give signals, okay? But I think with the given information, you can make the conclusion yourself. Plus, you know all the things we use in the club. Go over the webinars. It's all covered there. Exactly. You see, you know the material. There we go. Okay. Where were we, guys? Dollar cut. Dollar yen. Same situation, 3+2, but this time to the downside, which means after ABCD, we want to see continuation lower. Pretty similar situation. Now, this is the way Vlad saw it, the way I saw it. Where is that Dorian? The way I saw it was in terms of range to look for the cells. Basically, we both look for cells, but one is looking it as ABCD level to be reached continuation. I was looking for it here to get the move to the downside. More or less, same idea, same direction, just slightly different execution. So we got the push up. We said that this is definitely not a buy opportunity because of the signs that we have against it. So we cannot treat it as, if you look at it as a range, you cannot treat it as breakout of the range. You know how to confirm these things, guys. Again, you have the webinars. And this is where Mr. Trump made the move. This guy is better than Chip Norris. Seriously, guys, look at it. Boom, we impose new tariffs, additions, and it drops. And it's really amazing to see how fundamentals, when they come above the daily chart, daily, weekly, and monthly, somehow it fits with the fundamentals, because fundamentals are moving the markets. I mean, that's obviously the case, the bigger moves, right? This short-term noise we see, it's robots, banks, something that happens intraday, some kind of move, right? But the overall trend, the big picture, when you zoom out and you see the price going down, this is fundamentals. So it's really magical to see how these two fit. And that's why many people are asking me, but why don't you follow on the fundamentals? Because, guys, when I look at the weekly, monthly, and daily charts, and I understand what happens there and what to look for next, for some reason, the fundamentals push it in that direction. That's the thing. Manipulations cannot happen on these higher time frames. High frequency trading and so on could spike, steal stops, and all these tricks and games that could be played or were played in the past. I have no idea. But on the higher time frames, you cannot do that. Okay? Well, only Trump can do that, but that's a different story. So basically, the fundamentals again found a way to match with the technicals, and we got the move. For me, it was that breakout below here, along with the divergence that was broken, and so on and so forth. I know many people are trading trend lines, so whatever floats your boat, I really hope you enjoyed that move. Now we're back to the bottom of this big move here. Okay. And we have a swing. So that means possible take profits if you did not cash out yet to be taken. And when we look at the bigger picture, let's not forget where we stand. This thing remains bearish for me because we're right here. This is a weekly range. And there is a very good chance we're going to see that zone, the 104.50 zone, reached, maybe even breakout. Problem is, I don't really see clearly what's happening here in that zone. I don't have a read, but on the shorter term, I think we're in a range and the bottom is yet to be reached. So Dorian remains bearish, guys. Of course, don't sell here. We need to see a setup, a logical setup, in order to sell it. All right, then we go to indices and commodities. And what we can see here is a false break. That false break is coming together with one leg divergence, and we have bearish pressure from this move. Now, the 61.8 was not yet reached, which is the tricky part, because we have exposure to this zone to be tested, but price action is suggesting that we're already there. That means we go to these charts and we see the reversal pattern is here. It attempted to continue higher and invalidated. It failed. So this is where we remain bearish and continue looking for these sales to be happening. My question has not been taken. Sorry, mate. What was your question? I don't see it in the chat. Mayova, please post your question again. The only thing I see from you is my question has not been taken. So if you can please repeat it, we're going to cover it, no problem. So here we have bearish expectations. Same happens with the next one for S&P. Absolutely, well, not absolutely the same, but pretty much the same idea. We're looking at the same setup. And this one is actually moving better, in my opinion. So continuation lower is what we are expecting to see. Gold and silver. The idea was to get two waves and buys. One leg divergence, bottom, something like that. Now, this is where it actually moved a bit quicker again because of the news. So it was starting to push lower, but boom, we got the spike to the upside. So it moved. If you catch it, well done. I personally did not trade this one because the setup was not clear. In silver, we had similar situation. Let's start with the 4-hour chart this time. Pullbacks to provide buy opportunities. That's the daily chart. Absolutely beautiful push up. Trend lines, levels. So basically pullbacks and continuation from the zones that we can mark on the way up would be the plan. The question is, guys, and this is the weekly view. The question is with both silver and gold, the shorter term. And in my opinion, in the shorter term, that was supposed to, maybe it will still provide it, considering that it managed to stop here based on the news yesterday, which after all created the hidden divergence. But we didn't have confirmation that this move is over. Okay, look at it. All the signs on the MACD, RSI, none of it is telling us this is the bottom. That's why one more push lower would make much more sense, in my opinion. And once this push is completed, this leg, then looking for the buys would make much more sense. However, that opens another question and probability or possibility, which is going to be impulsive move, 5-leg structure. That means a correction is happening as impulse. This is where we have two options, pullbacks and one more leg in order to create the bigger ABCD, or this is AB, that's the entire leg, and we continue higher. Similar as with the dollar cut pair, I believe. So that's what we're following. In the very short term, as for now, clarity is right here on this leg. We need to see one more push lower, at least to that zone. After that, we need to see whether it's going to be double wave, divergences, and so on, to give us the triggers for the low, to create new lows. Or it will gain the momentum, and usually when that happens, you don't get conservative entries for sales. Probably not even trendline breakouts for sales. So one is always invalidating the others, and it's kind of cool to trade it this way and manage it this way, because probably 9 out of 10, you just stick with whatever is given, the facts, and you trade it. Okay, Doc, now let's check out your question. Your cut. What of if we have a break? What if we have a break out of the zone and just above that level we have a bearish setup? Can such setup be taken? I have seen some situations like that. Okay, let's open the chart. Euro cut. What if we have a breakout of the zone? Are you, first of all, which zone are you referring to? This zone? The resistance? And just above that level, we have a bearish setup. So basically your idea is we break, and this is where we have sell setup. No, I would not. Can you, however, tell me why not? I mean, of course you can, but why would that be tricky, risky, and aggressive? Guys, any ideas on this question? If that happens, what's your idea? Would you sell here? Come on, let's include everyone. Okay, we have a few yes, a few no. Okay. Anyone else, guys? We have third option, okay, Kevin. All right. Okay. So a few people said yes, few people said no. But basically, in my opinion, this is a solid no here, because it's simple, guys. You have a zone, a level, and everything starts with a level. Once the price positions itself above this level, ignore everything else, go back to the basics. If you're above a support and you're very close to this support, why not look for buys? Why look for sells? What did we just discuss? Where is USD CAD? Come on, I don't see it here. This is exactly what we discussed. You have a buy setup right in front of the resistance. Of course, you can expect for this move to happen, that huge spike, not spike, the big candle, the big red candle to happen. There is so much pressure and you're hitting that zone. I mean, it's like standing in front of a wall and trying to sprint, right? Of course, you're going to hit the wall. That for me is absolutely the same. What pair was that? Eurocat. There are other, not opportunities, but other suggestions here. Wait for actual pullbacks and buy. With this one, I agree. Wait for break of this zone once again, then pullbacks and sell. With this one, I would also agree. But as a rule of the thumb, I would be buying here and selling here. Perfect. Thank you, Doc. And everyone else for the opinions. Money, yes, we can cover it. No problem. Let me just finish with the list might from the report and then we can have a look at it. All right. So indices, we covered gold and silver. We were saying that we want to see deeper pullback here in silver, and then decide this or that. But overall, short term, we might have sell opportunities, but overall, we're looking for buys. That's the bottom line. Then we go to the stocks. And Adidas Now, for some it's invalidated, for some it's not. That's why it was left in the report to maintain the idea, but basically it spiked up here. And I don't know. I would not, if you're still going to trade it, I would not change this level. That remains still a fantastic level to work with. So spike up or not, the divergences remain if we get the breakout, but only here where the original level was. I will not shift it upward to catch a better move. So this one, if you don't mind the upside move here, the spike to the upside, still valid. Then Deutsche Bank, not going to comment on it. It's long term, very long term. This one provided spikes to the downside. It was based on the levels here, the divergences. It stopped, it started creating the idea of the reversal. And that's where the magic happened. And we finally got some kind of momentum after all these candles here. Which was good from one point because it was holding, right? Which means, at least the way I see it, is we're gaining momentum, more and more people are joining, robots are joining, whatever, you know, whatever moves the market in that case is jumping in, triggers, and then boom, you have amazing moves. This is what happens usually when we have the contractions, right? So whether it's horizontal or shrinking pattern where the price is contracting, usually the breakouts are very strong. That's the logic behind it again. So this one is working pretty nice. Vivendi jumped up and, well, technically we have plenty of room until we get the breakout. So no real updates on this one. Now, let's cover oil. And oil money, to be honest, is absolutely not clear to me. I mean, we can have some general analysis here. What's happening and how is it happening? Which would be the trend line? That triple plus this thing here, which was the reversal. Pullbacks and continuations. However, once we broke this level, it became really not clear. Now, with the most recent events, we're back below the zone, which opens the doors for possible sales. Yes. And I think that that would summarize it. Bearish for me. We just need to find setups. And currently, I don't have any. That specific level is just a strong zone. I think it was somewhere around here. It was a strong zone. First of all, that was a previously created trend line, which was holding the price here. This is where the convergence happened on the daily cycle. And even if you have no clue at all about all the things I'm referring to, everyone has charts. And everyone can go ahead and draw levels. And when you go on the chart and put your levels and draw them, you want to see places with most density, basically where did the price stop most of the times. Like picking support and resistances manually. That's the easiest thing one can do, and you can make, well, lots of money, guys, only based on that. Of course, if you have further idea of how to confirm these trades, it would be much better, but it all starts from a level. So this is the first zone where we can see the price stopped, right? Then you have massive candles, and guess where the price stopped during that day, right here. One more. This is, as we said, the breakout zone. And then for a few days, you have the price fighting bulls and bears exactly again in this zone. So something is happening here. And if you're above, you don't want to be basically selling, right? And you don't want to be buying because you're still in a bearish trend. So that's why it became neutral for me. Now that we're back below it and the overall trend is bearish and I'm below this level, pullbacks could be interesting for sales, but we're not there yet. Perfect. Yeah, it's agree. It's actually great stuff indeed. And those are the very, very basics. I mean, that information is available to anyone, but people usually forget to go back to the basics, things that usually work. And these things don't cost money. But again, we somehow tend to complicate our lives in trading. I'm talking about the trading part. When it could be really simple. And I like simplicity, guys. I mean, I work with a few, we should call them methods, I guess, like the divergences, convergences. I am recently learning and trying to master the Elliott waves. I'm currently working with very specific setups, the clear ones, because I still have things which are too subjective for me. I cannot see them. And that's why I don't use them. I just stick to the black and white things that could be separated clearly. Is it yes? Is it no? And you have rules. And when you follow the rules, you can't lie. You can't be subjective, right? It's either yes or no. And again, sticking to the basics usually makes money. I mean, if it's been valid for so many years, why not? Guys, any other questions? Gold we covered, mate. Gold we covered. If you missed it, please watch the recording. All right, so that would be all then. I'm wishing you an amazing weekend. Go enjoy. It's summer and we continue next week. Money, yes, the recording will be posted in the free Telegram group that we have, the free community group. And also, of course, it's posted on YouTube. So the easiest way and the fastest way to get to it is to subscribe to our channel. And you get notifications once new videos are uploaded. So that would be all. Once again, thank you guys for being here with me, the discussions and all the questions. It was an honor as usual. Have a wonderful weekend.